Hello friends, my name is Anshita and you're watching my channel TechRight Education. In this video, I will continue with the interview questions which are asked when you go for the profile of desktop support, remote desktop support, technical support and so on. And this is part 6 of the tutorial. So let's begin our session. Now the next question is, what is DNS? So DNS stands for Domain Name System. Now, what is the use of DNS? Basically, DNS is used for converting name to IP and vice versa, that is IP to name. Suppose this is website name and we want to convert this name into IP address. So what we'll use? We'll use DNS server. If I want to convert again this IP address into this name, then I will use again DNS, because the function of DNS is to convert name to IP and IP to name. Now, what is the use of this conversion? Basically, we cannot remember every IP address, but we can remember name. That is why there is a process, that is DNS, which is used for converting the IP address into name. Now, what machines understand? Machines understand these IP addresses. So that's why there is a process, that is DNS, for converting name to IP address. Now, the next question is, give the main significance of the boot.ini file. So, boot.ini file is used for the boot process of the operating system. We all know that we have multiple sources of booting the system. As we can boot our system with the help of bootable pen drive, we can boot our system with the help of hard drive in which our OS is present. So, from where we get these kind of options? These all options are come because of boot.ini file. Sometimes we have multiple operating system in the same computer, so this also comes under boot.ini file. At some place it asks with us that from which OS you want to boot. When we select the OS and hit enter, it will boot from the selected OS. Now the next question is, what are the main sources of the viruses to enter in an operating system, and how can we prevent our system from these kind of viruses? So there are various sources from where viruses can come. The first one is internet downloads. When we download some kind of unwanted things from the internet, then what happens? Viruses come in our system. We get different kinds of mail from various places. Now, when we not see the mail clearly and click on that particular mail, then what happens? It affects our system. We get some kind of attachments in our email. When we open these attachments, then what happens? It infects our system. When we click on unwanted links, then what happens? It affects our system. Suppose we have infected CDs and DVDs and we play that particular CD and DVD in our system, then what happens? It affects our system. The next one is infected flash drive. Suppose we have a pen drive that is infected, that means it contains virus, then what happens? It also infects our system. Now, how can we get protected from these kind of viruses? As we all know that in Windows 10, we have Window Defender. But the tasks performed by Window Defender are limited. So, what we use? We use third-party softwares which are original, licensed, which protect our system from virus. And what kind of softwares these are? These are antivirus software. Now, the next question is, elaborate on the different types of operating system. That means that how many types of operating system we have. Basically, we have two types of OS, that is SOS, which stands for Simple Operating System, and the next one is NOS, which stands for Network Operating System. Now, what are the example of SOS? So the example of SOS is Windows 95, Windows 10, Windows 8, Windows 7 and so on. Now, what is example of network operating system? This is Windows Server 2016, 2000, 2003 and so on. The next question is, describe the common types of LAN cables used nowadays and what is the ideal length that can be used for proper communication through LAN wires. So there are some common LAN cables which are widely used, and these are Cat5 and Cat5e, which is UTP, that is unshielded twisted pair cable, and can support data speed up to 100 Mbps. Next one is Cat6 and Cat6e. This one is also unshielded twisted pair cable and can support data speed up to 1 Gbps.